Okay, so play some Hearthstone again today, as for the others also. Cam, you know, getting things set up. Slowly increasing my ability to do this. I think today we're going to play a fun deck. Something just a little bit more wacky and cool. So, one of my favorite decks to play, as you see, I have a few. This is also the same type. I have a few different Thief Rogues. I'm probably going to try to play a Thief Rogue today. Let me go ahead and get rid of these extra new cards that come out of this expansion that I really have not looked at since the expansion dropped all the way back last year? Might have been last year. I don't know. I don't have one zombie, right? I don't think so. We might have to build. We have to create one zombie and then go from there. As it stands, let's get all of these new cards out of here. And then we'll play some Thief Rogue. So, Thief Rogue. One of my favorite versions of deck really is very luck dependent, meaning that if you don't get lucky, you don't win. So, it can be fun. Does okay controlling the board, so it's kind of a Thief Rogue control build, I guess. But I really enjoy it. I think it's a fun way to get that. Set the master down just a little bit. Up against Priest. I really don't think that the two saps are necessary. I'll keep Sudden just in case it's a really aggro-centric tempo version of Priest. It doesn't happen terribly often. I am on my main account right now. So if you've watched one of my last videos and noticed I was ranked 25 and now I'm ranked 17, I've not gone off stream and ranked up a big bunch without you. I've just, I'm on my other account. Go ahead and play Blink Phlox next turn. I guess depending on his play this turn, I might Shadow Step Blink Phlox to get it again for one mana next turn. It also depends on what I get off of Blink Phlox. Oh, that's nice, though. Because that's another card that gives me a card from his class. Well, it's from his deck. Which means it's a good card from his class. Which is good. So, we'll get another copy of that later. Okay, so now we know we're playing Dragon Priest. I don't even know there was a Dragon Priest in the meta right now, honestly. I guess they have the 4-mana 3/3 board clear. So we'll have to see where this takes us. Need to change card back here pretty soon, too. I feel like I don't know what's going on with the sun. Let's make this a little bit more beautiful. Ooh, Kragwa, my boy. Okay. And there must be something special here, right? Whatever. I think I take out the draw engine, oddly. Sudden Betrayal on the board. I'll just Shadow Step here. So if he wants to trade into it, he's going to have to trade two. I get another steal on the board. Shadow Priest could come in handy, potentially. Reminds me of the, what was that old card? It was another one of their 1/3s that discovered a dragon if you had a dragon in your hand. It's like the little girl. 1/3 dragon girl. These are somewhat similar. That seems like a... such a bad play. Set it for an easy board clear. Go ahead and reset the weapon. What did I get Alistros off? I guess that was off of... Okay, yeah. That was off of, Crystalline. Which is good. Could be a good heal potential later. Just see what we get. Do I just want to play Cabal here? I don't think I do. I don't think I do just play Cabal here. It's way too early for Academic. Well, not really. I've got Tess in hand. So if I Academic this turn, I could potentially get 2 1 drops next turn. I just go ahead and some board. The fact that he's playing Alistraza heavily implies that he's playing some kind of OTK version of Dragon Priest, so he's probably running Cloning Gallery. Why would he run Cloning Gallery in a... No, he can't be running Cloning Gallery in a Dragon's deck. So that's not there. But he might be running Valen with 2 Mind Blast. That's not totally unreasonable. Just have 20 damage in the hand. But that's a pretty expensive play. Blink Fox is not bad here. Let's hand to your hand. I'll go ahead and do this first here. Draw a Death Rattle minion from your deck. I don't naturally have Death Rattle minions in my deck, so if I got one, it was from him, which is going to add to my test play. I'm trying very hard not to overdraw, though. And I'm close. So Dead Ringer, if I have another one, my deck will pull me to 9, so I'll draw, which I have a lot of cards in my deck. It doesn't matter if I overdraw too much. It might have been nice to wait. I have Valera in the deck, so that I could have got the 2 Academic Espionages for 20 cards rather than just the 1 for 10. But there's a chance that I just get a lot of value here. Yeah, he'll heal that. See, so I get, I do get a Death Rattle minion because of this, which is useful. Go ahead and... Ooh. Strelonji's interesting, because first off, I get her back with Tess, and she'll summon any card that didn't start in my hand. That includes Gilded, Alistraza, Cabal Shadow Priest. It's a quick way to empty out my hand, force him to use a big Mass Hysteria or something. It is a Dragon Priest, so Mass Hysteria could be really good, and Devour Mind is also really good. But so these two don't add, well... No, they would also add, so I get 3 cards off of Devour Mind from his deck, which could give me some pretty good cards. Mass Hysteria is a board clear. I'm going to take the really greedy play and go Devouring Mind. Go ahead and get my copy card off of Blink Fox here. Nice, a heal. See what he has in his hand. Oh, I got my Blink Fox back. I think I want to save Shadow Step for Tess. So I'm going to do that. Now, if I did go to Longi and he didn't have the board clear, which I think is unlikely, I could have got a sneaky kill with Alistraza. Well, no, because Solange would have summoned Alistraza. So I would not have reduced his health to 15 while having a big bunch of threats on board. So I think I made a reasonable play not taking Solange. Though, Mass Hysteria probably was very good. He's just not playing aggressively enough onto the board to really make it necessary. He's running really high on card count. He'll probably play a Blink Fox this turn. Or does that burn me? It does, doesn't it? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Yep. Oh, so that's fine. I think Tess is pretty good here. I know he has Alistraza in his deck, though. So it might be necessary to make this play. Shadow Reaper Anduin is big. So if you're not familiar with how this archetype works, basically, is that worth it? No, I still want to say that for Tess. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, I'm good. Basically, Tess does cards from another class, but if you play a hero that you've stolen from another class, including Shadow Reaper Anduin and all the hero cards, then you change classes. So you suddenly become a priest, and once you play Tess, it replays all of your rogue cards. And so if you get lucky, and you haven't really played that many rogue minions, you could potentially get something like, I don't know, for example. Ooh, I can burn him. That's good. If you get Tess out and you played Shadow Step, you can Shadow Step your own Tess just from playing Tess and do it like every turn, and it's pretty good. Here, go ahead and burn him a card. Heal myself for 10, which is for 8, but it heals me back up. So, I got to burn him for 1, which is really cool. Either. I didn't burn anything terribly important, but puts us a little bit ahead on board. He's going to have to reinvest a lot back into the board. He can steal with Cabal combo again, but I already have Cabal in my own hand, so I can take back whatever he... Well, I mean, not whatever he does it on, but what he does it on, because it's obvious that he's going to do it. So now I play Cabal, take that back. I'm going to go ahead and coin the Assassinate in his Cabal. Put myself just a little bit ahead. And let's put that back in my hand. So I have 10 healing just waiting around for 1 mana. Did it ding? That was for the preheat. Did you check the stove? It's not done yet. Huh? Was the timer done? You sure? Well, I'll get it here in a minute. So here is probably where I will play Shadow Reaper. Yeah. So I play Shadow Reaper here. And it kills 2 of his minions pretty readily. Do I? I don't know. Because I have the guaranteed amount there. Now I've got another heal for 10, which seems even better. And I can go ahead and take 7 from him. See what we pick up from the deck. Draw 4 seems pretty good. Return enemy to the hand. I'm going to take the Eternal. just give me a copy. It means Tess is gonna play it. Anduin seemed kind of okay, but I did not expect to pick up the whole combo with Cabal, where I would have probably saved that to take a little bit extra value. Not that I would have got too much more. I have 20 healing in my hand for 4. So this is where that control aspect of the deck kind of comes in, where as long as you get semi-lucky, you get a lot of control tools from their side, but even from my side with the vanishes, the executes, the sudden betrayals, also run one of the... Oh, what is that secret called? Dodge or whatever. It's the secret that lets you become immune after you take damage for the first time in a turn. So there's a few different things that we have. Here. It doesn't matter which one he attacks with. Preferably he would attack with a 3 first. Just so I mitigate a little bit less damage. But I still only take as much damage as I do. And then I heal right back up for 1. I think I can go ahead and play this. Let's go ahead and get Gilded. Play Tess. Shadow Visions. Yeah, the evasion. Oh, dang, I filled up my hand, didn't I? Whatever. I got a lot of value. As long as I don't mill Valera, I'm still pretty far ahead in value here. He's going to trade both into the 6-6. If he doesn't have a Hysteria or something, I have... No, I don't quite have Lethal on board, do I? I almost have Lethal on board. Well, if he does nothing, he just goes face for some reason. I do have Lethal on board. I'll just trade the 1-1 off and hit him for 10, 16, 17, 20 damage, which is exactly what he would be at if I Alexstrasza next turn. I still have another heal 10 in my hand in case something else comes up. If he plays a bunch of big creatures out of nowhere, I don't really know how he would do that. Yeah, I figured he'd take care of Tess. So he never knows if I have another, return to the hand effect or something, or I can always copy something. This is fine. So he just returned a bunch of deck stuff to my deck, which leaves me, again, just a little bit ahead. Go ahead and Alexstrasza here. Deal 9 damage. So he heals 5. He must have a 4 mana. Deal 3 to everything. Yeah. Duskbreaker. Trigger friendly minions. Death Rattle twice. Something. Keep. Ooh. Vanish is a good card to discover. Now, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I will burn again. But I have, a lot of cards in the deck. I'm not ahead, per se. But from here, it doesn't matter if I stay rogue. So, I can wait for a big threat and then Shadow Reaper. Yeah. Well, that was probably the worst deal I could have got. That would have been really good. Go ahead and heal 10. I can Sudden Betrayal here. Oh, I didn't have a dragon in hand. Yeah. Do I care to... I don't really care to evasion here. Could probably spend some time clearing up my board. Maybe I should have taken Sprint. Which right now the game plan is, I'm 12 cards ahead in Fatigue, so he's going to take a bunch of fatigue damage before I ever do. Unless, of course, he could have King Togwaggle randomly. I don't know if Dragon Priest potentially runs King Togwaggle. And a few other things there. I got rid of these teeth earlier. Look, the eyes should just come out there. No nose, though. Oh, nice. Another Omega Mind. Ooh. Temporus. How dangerous. Yeah, he could kill me this turn. If he just has the double-double inner fire, he goes up to 32, which is enough, as long as he doesn't play another minion. And as a priest, there's really no reason not to run it. Why'd you check for my secret? I didn't play a secret last turn, and he already popped my secret from the turn before. So he must be planning to play minions here. Yeah. Interesting. Here. If I play Temporus and Evasion, does it help me? Take 4. Yeah, I would take 4, and then I would take whatever he plays next turn. That's true. So I think I've vanished this turn. Go ahead and Gilded Gargoyle. Fortunately, I didn't get to burn him for anything again. I don't get the point of this side over here. That was such a waste of a board clear. If it kills me, it kills me. Let's see what happens. I don't think he can kill me. So this is really nice, because that means instead of taking two, I only take one this turn. Which might make the difference. Doesn't that last until... Is that to the end of the turn? This turn. Okay, I thought it was till my next turn. I was like, man, that would be awesome. What's in psychic screams? That seems really inefficient. Okay. You can't do that. Just interesting. Go ahead and ping me for two. Now I get two turns to develop. And heal back up a fool. Ooh, pretty good. I think this is still better, right? How far do I take him down? I'm just gonna keep that in my hand for now. Okay, so that leaves me lethal in hand. One mana Valen's pretty good. Double my hero power damage chain. If he heals enough, I'll just Shadow Reaper next turn if he gets some big threats out. Which he has to clear my board entirely, which means he needs a Mass Hysteria and needs to have good rolls. Well, actually, I think my board... On a Mass Hysteria, I think my board clears pretty much no matter what. I might have a 7-8 left after a Mass Hysteria. I think he's considering forfeiture. I'm 10 cards ahead of him. Guess he's out of time. That's just game. Oh, I didn't get to do the Valen Mind Blast combo. Awesome. Long game, but a good one. Hopefully you enjoyed. I always like, you know, control decks, thief decks, especially with Rogue, really, really fun. So, yeah, if you enjoyed, leave a like. Leave a comment. Tell me what I can do better. If you didn't like it, dislike it. And again, tell me what I can do better. I want to start building up an audience, playing games that everyone would really like to play. I really enjoy it. So yeah, have a good Monday. Thanks for watching.